grupper, må man vel kunne si. Jeg mener, se bare på dette tilbakeblikket. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
What happened to your headband? You remember that you used to have a headband?
Yeah, well, the old-fashioned lights used to be very heavy and very hot, and used to have big sprays of sweat coming off, and also couldn't see my cords for my tears.
So it actually had a function.
Yeah, that's original. That was the original idea.
I thought it was a fashion statement of some sort.
And then it actually did become quite useful because I wasn't recognized in the street, and I could walk around there. And then it went to a stage where it was no good. I had to start wearing a baseball cap. And now I just don't bother.
we were talking about monkeys here, and I read somewhere that you have a dinosaur named after you.
Yes, that's true. I think they must have been some misguided paleontologists. And they found something. It was some lizard, fierce lizard, I should add. And that's what it means, apparently. Yes, it's kind of nice, cool for kids, because the kids, little kids, they're all dinosaur experts. Have you know, they're all dinosaur experts now. So they thought it was pretty cool, my kids.
You're here with a new album, and actually it's kind of a miracle that you can sit here and talk about the new album, because you had an accident.
Yes, a lady, poorly, well, I'm kind of sorry for her, really. She's from Ecuador, and she didn't have a proper driving license. So...
And you were riding your motorcycle?
Yeah. Afraid I was.
What happened?
Well, I met the lady from Ecuador.
Do you remember anything from the accident?
I remember going up in the air a long way. I mean, I do remember actually going... I remember thinking, you're not going to do that, are you? And she did.
Oh, my God.
And I remember going up in the air and landing, you know, landing on my shoulder. But it was actually, you know, when I broke a few bones, but when you break a few bones, there's nothing much. I was pretty fit at the time, so there's not much you can do. I mean, I just asked if I could go home after a couple of days, and they said, well, okay, if you really must. I went home and just tried not to laugh. You know, and just took a lot of painkillers. Yeah, but I was sort of sat in a chair a lot of the time, and I ended up writing a lot of songs, and this album came, you know, like a lot quicker. So I was pretty pleased about the whole thing. Really.
Thanks to the lady from Ecuador. How could you play the guitar? I mean, playing a guitar with broken ribs and a broken bone.
Yeah, I couldn't. I mean, I couldn't at the beginning. I could play an electric one, which is pretty thin, so I managed that. Now that was okay. It got a bit iffy, but the acoustic, I was in big trouble getting my arm over there, and I thought, you idiot, you know, but it actually, it went, physio and everything, it it's 100% now, so it's fine.
So, some people would say that you are perhaps the world's best guitarist. How would you regard it? Where would you put yourself on that list?
No, I mean, it's nowhere. It's so wrong. I mean, I play... My playing is a mess. My playing is a mishmash. I would be a guitar teacher's worst nightmare, you know.
Why is that?
Well, I play... Everything is completely unorthodox. I play, I hold the neck like a plumber holds a hammer. And, you know, instead of all this business, it would be like this. And my I used to play with a piece of plastic they call a pick. You know, I still do. I like playing that way, the proper way. But I learned how to... I couldn't afford an amplifier when I was a little kid, so I learned how to finger pick. And then I just sort of did a... It ended up being a kind of a stew, you know, sort of a mix-up of the different styles, and I broke a lot of rules. The way I anchor my hand is wrong, and if I had a guitar teacher would come around and ring the bell and be there, would be very good for me, but he wouldn't be very good for him.
Still, it sounds okay.
Well, I like playing, and I always like playing. I used to fall asleep playing when I was a kid, you know.
Is this a gene? The musicality gene, or...?
There is for sure not just one gene. Mm-hmm. But it's interesting, actually, as we were speaking about FOXP2, this gene that is involved in language and speech, that if you test the family members that have this mutation versus the other ones...
Mutation.
Yeah, that knocks out this gene. And if you test them for musical ability, there's absolutely no difference in pitch, but in rhythm. So if you ask them to drum a rhythm, they have a big problem. So it seems that it has to do sort of with sophisticated muscle control. And the idea is that this hits through in our daily life, mostly in our language, where we need millisecond control between...
this musicality. Music
and yes, in musicality. Another fascinating thing from an evolutionary point of view is why we all enjoy music in all human cultures. And we have no indication that anyone else really does it.
What kind of music do you enjoy?
Well, I enjoy this kind of music. It's very good to listen to. And I think it says that that the test of the pudding lies in the eating. So no matter how you play, that's the sound of it and the joy of it that matters. And I think I also like country and western music. I'm one of the few Norwegians that love country and dare to admit it.
Mark Knopfler, your band is waiting.
Yeah, sorry.
Thank you so much. Okay, see you after.